I'm filming from Gen Con 2013 from my hotel room. I'm going to tell you a little bit about a new game by WizKid, which is being presented here at Gen Con, and the game is going to be released next week. The game is Star Trek Attack Wing. I was pretty excited about the game because it looked like a miniature game of space combat with a Star Trek theme. I went to the place where they were demoing it, and I watched some people playing it. I had a person from the staff explaining the game to me. They also asked me if I could film a little bit there and show the game. They told me no, you can't. So I thought, well, I'll just share my thoughts anyways here in my video in the privacy of my hotel room. Star Trek Attack Wing. Again, keep in mind I have not played the game, but I think I can give you some information beforehand, before the game is released. Maybe you'll still find it useful. Well, the game, I knew it was inspired by Star Wars X-Wing. I didn't know it was going to be inspired so deeply, to the point that the game pretty much looks like a re-themed version of Star Wars X-Wing with a Star Trek theme. The mechanics are the same. You have individual starships with initiative. They move in ascending order of initiative. They attack in descending order of initiative. You roll attacks and defenses in the same way. You have actions that you can use each turn in the same way. The critical, you have critical hits and regular hits that work exactly like in X-Wing. The only thing that I noticed here differently is that the dice seem to be a little better than those for X-Wings, because they're a little more easily readable. The difference between the critical hits and regular hit is much more visible on these dice. Other than that, the game seems pretty much the same. There are a couple of different things. So there's a couple of maneuvers, of maneuver templates that are not available in X-Wings. For example, here you have a straight six. You have a bank four, but other than that, my idea is that I have already played the game, even though I haven't, because it is so similar. I'm sure that when you look at the cards, when you look at the weapons, there will be things that will be different, but such differences can be brought through the cards and through individual ships and stats of characters. These things can be brought to the X-Wings universe too. The mechanics are the same. Certainly they must have been customized a little bit differently here, in some cases with different stats for certain ships, but the same can be done with other game. The same probably will be done with other expansions, will be added to Star Wars X-Wings. So my first impression is that well, since I have the other game, I really didn't feel any urge and not any particular desire to own this game either. I started building my collection of Star Wars X-Wing. I already spent some money there. I didn't see the reason to add another game that plays pretty much exactly the same. If I hated the Star Wars theme and I loved the Star Trek theme, maybe, but frankly, I like both the franchises, I like both the universes. If anything, something that bothers me a little bit is that in the cards that identify the characters that control the starships, and the cards that have the stats, the combat factors, the actions, so on and so forth, those cards in Star Trek Attack Wing, the illustration is a picture. It's a picture from the TV shows or the movies of the Star Trek Next Generation. That is, you have a card with a picture of Picard, of the guy that plays Picard. Somehow, to me, pictures from movies are less thematic in games than illustrations. Because, well, I have miniatures, I have illustrations on the board, I'm not watching a movie. In a certain way, illustrations from movies, I don't know, create a certain visual discontinuity for me. It is harder to integrate components that have pictures as part of the overall experience than it is to me, for example, when I play Star Wars X-Wing, and I see there is a drawn illustration of a starship on the card, and then there are drawn things on the other components, on the other cards. It just seems to create a visual continuity. A quick look at the models of Star Trek Attack Wing also gave me the sense that the miniatures are less attractive and less detailed than the miniatures that you have for X-Wings. They're similar, they just seem a little less detailed. The paint also appeared to be less detailed. Could it be that it was just a demo copy that was being shown there? Maybe, maybe that's it. But in that case, I think it was a very unwise decision to showcase a copy that is not the best copy available that you had. One copy came back from China and the paint wasn't all the details, wasn't all that it could be. And they decided to put that one out on a table at Gen Con. I think that's bad policy. Bottom line, haven't played a game and I'm almost reviewing it because I feel like I played it already. I certainly feel like I don't need to spend more money to start a new collection of a game that I already have that is so mechanically similar to a game that I already have. If you're a Trekkie and you cannot live without one of the million of things that come out every year with a Star Trek theme, then probably you will want to add this game to your collection. Otherwise, for just a gamer that wants to play game, if you played X-Wing, I don't see any reason why probably you would want to add this game to your collection. I'm not going to. If you want to, well, that's good for you. Maybe you invite me to your place and I'll come and play your game, but this is not a game that is going to be in my collection.